Stephen O'Hara is with me this afternoon from OptiBiotix. Stephen, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Andrew.
Tell me a bit more, if you would, about Stephen Prescott. Stephen, you're your new chief executive of ProBiotix Health.
Yeah, he's a great appointment and comes with a good track record, and he comes from a history of working with some very large companies. But just to set the context, first of all, for investors who may not understand the process, what we're trying to do here is build a company, OptiBiotix Health PLC, number of divisions, so one being skin biotherapeutics and another being probiotic health, but to get to a point, particularly probiotic health, where it becomes self-sustainable. It's developing revenue, so it becomes self-sustainable. And then we build a team around it, which is very much commercially focused, to take it to the next level, which could mean then putting on one of the public markets, either in the UK, Europe, or the US, or Canada. And what Steve brings is that commercial expertise, that network of contacts, that international presence from working as the vice president of marketing and applications at a Probi, which are a well-established probiotic company. So he has that probiotic expertise, which has about 604 million Swedish krona sales. So a biggish company, and Steve brings a lot of experience, a lot of contacts, and probably more importantly, a strong track record of building revenues within probiotic companies. So a very good good appointment.
And what's the significance of him being based in the US?
Yeah, very, very good question. So the US is one of the biggest probiotic markets. It's grown at a very fast rate out in the supplement market at about 55% per year. So having an individual who knows the US market, is based in the US market, puts us in a strong position. Steve will cover the US and also cover Asia, which is another developing market, which is starting to build up a lot of traction. And Luis Gonzalez will cover Europe. I guess the other point to bring out is having a presence in the US creates opportunities to take probiotic health to maybe one of the American or Canadian public markets. So it's another option for probiotic as it goes forward. But the key to this is that we continue the strong growth that we've had, both in terms of science and revenues within the probiotic health division, and we take that forward and build revenues and we build value in this area for shareholders, both of probiotic health, if at least, but also of its parent company, OptiBiotix Health PLC. So strategically, it's a great appointment for those reasons, that it brings expertise, but also location, which is important as we look at our strategic options going forward.
Is there any further detail that you can give? You mentioned continuing the strong momentum and the growth there, but what about your expectations of him and his performance?
The way OptiBiotix works, it employs high-performing individuals. So we have a small team, six people, who are all highly motivated, and we give them options. So if they deliver on increase in revenues and doubling the share price, which is often linked into their to their options, then they'll get adequately well rewarded. And so as we build the company, we need to change the team and change the skill sets. And what you see now with the appointment of Fred Narble and Steve is that we're bringing in specialist commercial expertise, so sector-specific expertise. An expectation is that they will deliver revenue growth for each of those areas. And you can immediately see over the last month and a half since Fred's joined us, the growth in SlimBiome deals. And of course, the deals that we've signed have all come with revenues. Mm. So that's the expectation that these people are brought in with this commercial expertise, with this track record of building revenues, that they carry forward that with OptiBiotix.
Well, a couple of deals announced since you and I last spoke. Let's have a couple of words on each, if we would. Most recently, this distribution deal for Go Figure in Poland. Who's it with?
That's right. It's with a company called Extensa. This is part of a strategy to take our own brand, whether that's Colbiome or Colbiome XXX for LPLDL or Go Figure for slim biome to other parts of the world. And what this then does, if people are buying GoFigure, then they're buying GoFigure product from us, but they're also indirectly buying slim biome. So we get money or revenue from the sale of slim biome to the manufacturers, but also revenue from the sale of GoFigure to our distribution partners. So that's part of a strategic movement towards selling more own label products abroad. That's important because that builds up the value of the GoFigure and ColdBiome brand, which are product brands, own label product brands, and that starts to attract a lot of global interest from partners who want to buy into a brand that's been established internationally. The other deal was a slightly different deal, which was with a group called Primo, who are based in Thailand, and they've acquired the rights to distribute slim biome, so they're buying slim biome. So whereas Extensa are buying in end product, go figure, Primo are buying in slim biome, so the core ingredient. And the one before that that we announced was an even more interesting one for the group called Nutrilinear that we've had a number of deals with in the past. And that was to create a new product that extends the application of LPLDL into hypertension. An interesting thing with that particular deal is that they're paying for the manufacturing scale-up, the manufacturing studies, the clinical studies, the development. But we have, of course, all the rights to the product because if investors can remember back 2 years or so ago, we filed a number of patents which gave us rights for not just LPLDL, but LPLDL in any combination for any cardiovascular problem, whether it's hypertension, cholesterol, etc. So all these things happen well in advance. And now what investors are seeing is the materialization of that that forethought in terms of setting the patents, creating the brand and taking these brands internationally. As indicated earlier, what we found both with the Extensa deal, as well as licensing GoFigure, they bought product immediately for sale, and Primo bought a large amount of slim biome immediately. So you can see the interest and the excitement momentum is really building, not just in terms of the agreements. We've had 40 now since we started, make four in May, but the momentum in terms of sales revenue. So an exciting month, May, and let's hope we can do just as well, if not better, in June.
Stephen, good to catch up. Thanks for the update.
Thanks, Andrew.